Hello everyone, my name is Andy from Lunatico Astro, and welcome to the third part of our series on the CloudWatcher. Today we'll begin looking at the CloudWatcher software in detail. There is a lot of ground to cover, so this video will be in three parts. You can either watch them all from start to finish, or choose the sections that most interest you. In part two of the series, I mentioned that if you own the Solo, then you may not need to install the CloudWatcher software at all. If that is the case, you can jump straight to part 4 of this series, which is dedicated to configuring and using the Solo. We'll start with the CloudWatcher software running in master mode and not yet started. The software can be divided into two sections. The central part comprises of 6 tabs, and the central display varies with the tab that is selected. Later, we'll see that some tabs have a further menu of secondary tabs on the right-hand side. Some of the tabs are used to display information from the CloudWatcher, and some are used to change its settings. It's very important to understand that the changes and settings you make here will mostly only affect the computer that you are working on. Let's take a moment to understand what that means. You'll recall from the previous video that we can connect a computer as either a master or a remote installation with or without a Solo. This means that a single CloudWatcher could provide data to a theoretically limitless number of remote users on the local network. Each of these users will receive the same raw data from the CloudWatcher via the parameters transfer file, but each user can choose to interpret this information in a way which suits their needs. For example, one user may choose to close their roof if the wind exceeds 20 km per hour, whilst another may be happy to keep the roof open until 50. This might seem quite obvious, but as we will see, the CloudWatcher offers many opportunities to fine-tune its algorithms, and this is particularly the case when it comes to sky temperature. Occasionally, we receive support queries from users asking why the CloudWatcher software and the Solo show different values. The answer is almost always that the settings of the Solo config page and those of the CloudWatcher software differ. Certain parameters can only be set one way and in one place. The CloudWatcher parameters transfer file is a good example. The path for this file can only be set from the master installation, whilst the single line data and JSON files can be created by remote installations. We'll start to look at the individual tabs in the next video. But first, I'd like to look at the common controls and information. As the name suggests, this is the information that is available regardless of which tab is selected and forms an L shape around the tabs section. We'll start with a look at the menu. Under File, there is an option to start and stop the unit and the Exit command. You're unlikely to need this menu, as the Start-Stop button is available as one of the common controls, and you will probably choose to exit the program via the X in the corner of the main window. The Help menu has a little more to offer. Here you will find a link to the online manual and the About section that shows basic version information of the software. The next control is the Start-Stop button. This is what we use to connect to the CloudWatcher hardware, or, in the case of a remote installation, the parameters transfer file. If a menu option appears greyed out, this can be because the device is running. Stop the device and you will often find that you have access to the setting. Below the Start-Stop button, there appears to be an open area. However, when we start the software, this quickly fills with a summary of the general weather conditions. Later on, we'll see how we can tailor this information, for example, to your own native language. We'll also see where the colours come from and how to change them to suit our preferences. For now, note the blue dot below the summary. This moves left and right to show that the connection to the CloudWatcher is working correctly. The dot may appear red whilst the software initialises the connection to the CloudWatcher. Below the summary section is a box which hopefully displays a green dot. As you have probably guessed from the label, this is the safe-unsafe indication, and it turns red any time that an unsafe condition is detected. The dot is quite small to allow space for a button to cancel the audio alarms. Audio alarms and determining the safe-unsafe condition are topics that we will revisit when we look at the unsafe tab. The next section is the record section. Here you have the possibility to record the output of the CloudWatcher in the CSV format. You may require this information for a variety of reasons, including creating a log file if you are experiencing problems with your CloudWatcher. We'll look at the parameters that you can set when we consider the Setup Network tab later on. Below the Record section is the status of the physical switch. You'll recall from the previous video that the switch is connected to a general purpose cable that can interface with various hardware and is especially suited to use with the Dragonfly. You might wonder why the switch is closed, although the CloudWatcher is reporting safe. We'll find out the reason for this when we look at the Setup tab. The last section is the status bar and window. Here you will see various status messages that usually relate to the software's interaction with either the CloudWatcher's hardware, such as the status of the serial link, or with the computer. For example, messages relating to the data files will appear here. Occasionally, you may see a 3-digit alphanumeric code appear in the window at the bottom right of the screen. Right-click to see a summary of the messages and consult the online manual for more information about the various codes. That concludes our look at the common controls and indications. Join me for the next part as we start to learn more about the tabs section.